So my name is Maya Amjadi. I am a sophomore here, biology Spanish double major, and I am doing research with staph bacteria in the NASIF lab in the inflammation program. You may recognize this picture of Blake Griffin. He's been in the news a lot this week. He is a basketball player who is out for several weeks because of a staph infection in his elbow that he actually has to get surgically drained. But staph infections don't only occur in athletes. Actually, staph bacteria is very common in our environment. And 1 in 4 people actually have staph bacteria on their skin and in their nose and mouth, yet they don't show symptoms of staph infections because they're not actually affected. Our bodies are super good at putting up these protective barriers like our skin and our mucous membranes that don't allow the bacteria to get inside, and so it doesn't cause any harm. Staph bacteria is spread very easily through skin contact, which is why so many athletes, like Blake Griffin, do contract staph infections, but also through sharing clothing, towels, and pillowcases, so spread very easily. So just on the surface, staph bacteria is not a problem. It's once it gets inside that it causes infection. So this picture here is of a foot with an open wound or cut. And this is how the staph bacteria gets from on our skin, where it's not problematic, to inside where infection occurs. During this time, someone with a staph infection would experience symptoms such as redness, swelling, heat, and inflammation. So this is how you know you have a staph infection. And staph bacteria are the primary cause of skin infections and soft tissue infections, but they also cause more severe complications, including pneumonia, sepsis, and the bone and joint infections, such as Blake Griffin has. So it can be very problematic. And so the primary treatment for a staph infection is antibiotics. And because of the overuse of antibiotics, have developed antibiotic-resistant strains of staph bacteria, which is especially problematic because it infects otherwise healthy individuals, but also it's really hard to get rid of. My primary focus in the lab is looking at bacteria, staph bacteria, once it's inside the body. So here I have a white blood cell. They're the first responders to a staph infection in the body, and their job is to engulf and destroy the staph bacteria, and they're super good at it. They eat it up, and then they pretty much just blast it with bleach, and it gets completely destroyed. Only a small percent survive within the white blood cell. What I'm interested in is during this time, particles are released from the surface of the white blood cell, and I've actually seen that they actually have a pro-inflammatory response. So it's really interesting that white blood cells are shutting down infection, yet allowing the release of particles that allow the signal to continue and spread infection throughout the body. So future therapies could use this knowledge of what I've found to target these sites of the outside of the white blood cell to shut down infection before it spreads. Thank you.